ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्मविद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंशर्षभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान गण प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्नपादिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మి కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, verse number 18 of 6th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Vacha Yada Viniyatam Chittam Atmanyeva Vatishthate Nisprahas Sarva Kamebhyaha Yukta Yityuchyate Tada. Bhagavan Krishna gave Bahiranga and Antaranga Sadhanani from verse number 1 to 17. Bahiranga sadhanas to be observed for a life long by a meditators. Antaranga sadhana is the immediate sadhanas to be observed during the meditation. Then now from these words, Bhagavan Krishna brings dhyana swarupam and phalam. When he talks about dhyana swarupam, all the acharyas interpret one more person's method called Patanjali. Rishi Patanjali has created excellent methods and he also has the philosophy. He has set Abhyasa and Tattva together called Patanjali Yoga Sutras. Those Patanjali Yoga Sutras are very famous. Whenever there is a topic about meditation, now Patanjali is the main person who comes in front. We cannot avoid Patanjali. Whatever the scriptural study we make, whenever it comes the topic about meditation, you cannot avoid him. Now the acharyas explain, this dhyana swarupam, it needs to be prepared. In order to go into the dhyana swarupam, we should also follow the practices which are prescribed by Patanjali Maharishi. He has set sadhana pada as ashtanga yoga. The yama niyama asana pranayama pratyahara dharana dhyana samadhi. These first five limbs are known as practices abhyasa oriented. This abhyasa oriented alone Bhagavan Krishna has given as Bahiranga and Antaranga sadhanani. But Patanjali way of approach also to be observed by us. Today a little bit we are going to stick with Patanjali's method. He begins the first stage of the meditation is known as Yama. Yama means there are five subdivisions are available. We call it Ahimsa, Satya, Asteya, Brahmacharya, Aparigraha. Ahimsa means what? This not to harm anybody. In fact, Yama means it's don't. Niyama means do's, don't and do's, or do's and don'ts. Yama means that is to be avoided. Niyama means that has to be adopted. Now first Yama to be followed. Because being a human being, we have to remove all animality first. The first is ahimsa. The animals follow himsa. Their lifestyle itself is endowed with himsa. In order to survive, they kill other creatures. We have to avoid that attitude first. Therefore, Bhagavan Patanjali, he brings Yama from the ahimsa. Ahimsa to be avoided. How to avoid himsa? From the mind itself, you have to remove harming others. I should not do harmful things others. From the mind, whenever there is a thought of harming somebody else, I have to withdraw from that thought. I should not engage to be endowed with that thought. I have to withdraw myself from that thought. I have to endowed, or I have to be endowed with a positive thoughts. That's a himsa, to be withdrawn or to be removed from our mind. We should not go along with. And when we speak, we should not harm. We should not scold at anybody. And while speaking also, we should not harm anybody. And our actions also, it should not harm anybody. This ahimsa is paramo dharma. All other dharmas are kept based on this ahimsa. Now the second one is satyam, to speak truth. Now there are two kinds of meaning given in Vedantic Shastra. We have ritam and satyam. Satyam means a vyavaharika truth. Ritam is paramarthika truth. In day-to-day transaction also, this both kind of satyam must be observed. You know, I went to a city, I stayed at a place, I wanted to see a temple. So that temple is a very famous temple, Lord Krishna's temple. But I was not aware how to go on the street, because that's nearby. I wanted to go by foot. Just, you know, having work, we can reach those places. I asked the person who was sitting in the opposite shop, Baba, how can I reach the temple? That's what my question. Then he said, Swamiji, take straight and take left and take one more left, you can reach Krishna's temple. Then I started walking. I kept on walking for half an hour. Then I thought, okay, somebody told within 10 minutes you can reach the temple, but more than half an hour, being crossed so many streets, the Krishna temple is not visible. Then I inquired from somebody else. He said, Swamiji, you are traveling towards opposite side. The temple exists direct opposite to this direction. Then I thought, what went wrong? I made sure again the same temple which I am inquiring about. He said, yes, I am sure. Then he asked, where are you from? Where you started from? And I told the place where I was staying. Then he said, oh my God, you should take right from that place. You have taken left. Then I didn't say that somebody has misled me. And I reached again. So when I reached again, that person who was sitting asked, Swamiji, did you have proper darshan? And I got a little bit irritated, why he is continuing with this lie. Then I just said, you know, no, that temple is not that side, somebody told me. At that time, his son had come from inside, which temple Swamiji asking for? Then I said, Lord Krishna's temple, which is famous one in this city. Then he said, again, this father was telling, you know, Swamiji, you should go a little bit, you know, ahead. Then the son said, Papa, what are you talking about? Swamiji should have taken this side. You misled Swamiji. Then he accepted, acha. So a little bit, you know, I was confused. Now, my question, did he lie or not? So lying means what? You know something, you are talking against, you are hiding that. But that person himself, he confirmed, he was thorough and he had the determination the temple exists on the right. But temple exists on the left. But he directed me what he thought was true. Therefore, he spoke satyam, but that satyam is not governed by the ritam. That path is known as ritam. That, so whatever that you think, the idea that you are speaking as it is called vak satyam, vyavaharika satyam, that has to be governed by a ritam. So the temple, he should have been connected properly with the temple, but he has lied off of the way, but he has also observed satyam, vak satyam. This both ritam and satyam must be together, then alone you are following proper satyam according to Patanjali. When you live a life, you should not lie, and you should know before talking, is it true or not? You should have proper knowledge before talking. If at all you are having proper knowledge, you should not hide anything. You should speak, you should transact well. This becomes the second discipline in the Yama. Then the third one is known as Asteyam. It's a very subtle but very strong discipline. Asteyam means you need not to be a robber. You need not to be a looter in order to loot the bank, in order to do the theft. No. You own others' things. You know, there is a story. In the long back in Puranic time, there were two brothers, Shankar and Likhita. So these two people were brothers. They had their own ashrams nearby. The Shankar ashram has got lots of fruit trees. Once this Likhita had gone to Shankar's place, means elder brother's place, the brother was out. Just he was sitting under the tree and there was beautiful fruits. Then he saw that might be mango or apple, I don't know which fruit. He took 3-4 fruits. The Shankar has reached. Then he said, you know, what are you doing? Though he was the brother, but he spoke what to be spoken. He said, you have not taken permission from me. So, not taking permission from somebody, though they are relative, doesn't matter. It is considered as the stealing that object. Stealing materials, stealing ideas, stealing the others, all belongings. And even considering those objects belong to us, when it belongs to somebody else, it is as equal to stealing alone. This Asteya means non-stealing. Then Shankar suggested him to go to his Raja, king. He reached the king. The king's name was Sadyumna. After considering, having discussion with the ministers, he said, you have stealed mangoes, fruits from your brother's place. Therefore, your both hands to be removed. Then punishment was made. Both hands were removed. This younger brother, happily he went to brother. So, I got punished. Now, I become pure. Then Shankar suggested, okay, go and do Sandhya Vandana. Sandhya Vandana means in order to do Achamana, you should have both hands. But when the elder brother says, he went to river, he took snanam, and when he sat for Sandhya Vandana, automatically he got back both hands. It was the story. Now stealing others' ideas or materials, having thought of stealing or owning their object which they don't belong to us, is known as theft alone. Stealing, non-stealing becomes a discipline. Why do we study all these things in order to do meditation? Because our mind, you know, you think they belong only to us. But when you hide something, when you steal something, when you disturb others, when you harm others, you're at the same time, your mind also gets the impact. You cannot maintain your peaceful mind. You cannot be relaxed. So you cannot be relaxed after stealing somebody's things. The mind will have, because the consciousness is there. It knows what is dharma and what is adharma. When you are aware about something, you are going wrong, that going wrong, stealing somebody's or harming somebody, or even lying something, your mind becomes completely aware. It won't allow you to take rest. Therefore, we have to be very careful. These are all known as Bahiranga Sadhanas. But Patanjali is very careful with every transaction which comes out. Then next comes Brahmacharya. Brahmacharya, here he gives the solid meaning. Not having inappropriate attitude towards opposite gender. That is, it is more fluctuating, deviating, and sucking all the energy from you. Having your mind, every married person also should have this attitude, the suggestion from Patanjali. Then your energy will be saved. That Brahmacharya Vrata is the Mahavrata which was observed by Bhishma. Not even thinking in wrong way. That's what I said, not having inappropriate attitude from the both gender. We need not blame. That's a natural force. We have to have the positive way to approach it. When you grow, when you become matured, you become a human being. That human name is will respect others. Having or setting a positive thoughts, not with hatred, positive thoughts, not having, that's the tendency of the animality should be avoided. Brahmacharya Vratam. Because when we instinctively become addict for those kind of activity, small activity, then immediately we will set the guilt consciousness inside. In order to avoid that, we have to be very careful. And the next is aparigraha. Not having possessions, not owning too much things. Be careful with the materialist, having with the limited materials. Because when you have too much materials, it will collapse your peace of the mind. Because you have to take care of them. Even it depends on you. Because even brahmacharis who are sticking with one or two dress, they may have the attachment. You have to develop kind of detachment according to the Vedanta. So you may be a king, but you should have the detachment. When you have the attachment, that will disturb you. Therefore, Janaka could sit in the meditation for a long in front of the Guru. He could sit without deviating himself when his city was on fire. It's the best example for us. When you want to be a successful meditator, you have to be endowed with all these preparations. Therefore, non-possessions becomes the fifth of Yama. All these don'ts are known as Yama, five-folded Yama. Then Niyama means it is to be done, the five kinds of regulations. We call it Shaucha Santosha Swadhyaya Stapa Ishvara Pranidhanani. This is also a sutra from Patanjali Maharaj. Shaucha means you have to be clean in and out. See, outer clean can be done with water. The inner clean can be increased by having stotras, parayanas, doing japa, puja. All these things in order to maintain that inner serenity, which is known as purity. That saucham, it becomes the first discipline for a meditator. And in Puranas, in histories, we saw that yogis are not taking even bath. they are with beard which is contending all the dirt, become, you know, like knots. No, it's not like that. Rishis, they maintain the cleanliness well. Santoshaha, maintaining happiness in his mind, not having any lacking in his mind or longing in his mind, being with contentment is known as Santosha. The next is called Swadhyaya. We have seen in the last chapter itself, in the fourth chapter, I suppose, Dravya Yajna Stapo Yajna Yoga Yajna Stathapare Swadhyaya Yajnana Yajnascha Yatayasam Shitavrata. There we have seen everything. But here, Swadhyaya means to be endowed with all the scriptural studies. That becomes a main discipline. It is to be done. Tapaha means austerity, having simple life. Tapaha means also, I have explained a lot, tapaha means to burn. To burn means what? Increasing heat. Heat in the mind means what? So voluntarily, willfully giving some kind of discipline to be followed, called tapas. Upavasam is a tapas. So like there are so many tapas methods we introduced long back itself. Then finally, Ishvara Pranidhanam. Prapattihi, what we call it? Prapattihi. Ishvara Pranidhanam means surrendering to the Ishvara everything. This surrendering is a big lesson one should learn how to do. In the first chapter, Arjuna was blabbering like anything. He was not surrendering. In the second chapter alone, he surrendered. Shadhimam Tvam Prapannam. Then alone, Bhagavan started pouring Gita. Otherwise, he would have not received. If he would have not received, we would have not got Bhagavad Gita. This Ishvara Pranidhanam is to be understood well. We have a separate chapter called Bhakti Yoga. There we will take care of it. Now these 10 commandments are known as disciplines, Bahiranga Sadhanani and Antaranga Sadhanani by Patanjali Maharishi. Okay. After this Yama and Niyama, which are Bahiranga Sadhanani, then comes Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara. So these are all Antaranga Sadhanani. Asana means to sit, it's an immediate sadhana. So you need not to do whole day asana. And pranayama, you need not to do whole day. When you sit for meditation, you have to see the prana samyam, that equanimity, balanced breath. That breathing must be endowed with a proper measurement. Breathing techniques, then pratyahara. Pratyahara means not allowing your mind to travel towards out. Completely inverted attention mind, known as pratyahara. Then comes dharana, dhyanam, samadhi. This dharanam, dhyanam, samadhi is the main core, which is known as also samyama by the technical term of Patanjali. Therefore, this chapter also known as Atma Samyama Yoga. So Patanjali gives so many other additional technical terms. He calls it Swadhyaya Tapaha Ishvara Pranidhanaha as a Kriya Yoga. There is an institution even in Lakshmanjula Rishikesh, Kriya Yoga. And they have their own traditional Baba, they say. They follow these techniques, Kriya Yoga. They give in different way, but the Patanjali is the author for their lifestyle. Now, here in the 18th verse, he concludes, Yada Chittam Viniyatam Chittam Atmanyeva Avatirthate. Viniyatam Chittam means the disciplined mind through Yama and Niyama, which can be very suitable mind for meditation, in order to sit for the meditation, then dharana begins. The dharana swarupa is said in the 19th verse. Let us read. Yatha dipo nivatasthaha nengate sopam asmruta yogino yata chittasya yunjato yogam atmanaha. Dharana means, first we have to understand, dharana means bringing all the attention together and fixing on one object or subject. There effort remains when you sit in front of Deepajyoti or in front of a lamp or in front of some material, make a lotus or something. So when you are withdrawing all the attention from all the directions, you just focusing on them. So mind goes away, you are bringing back. Mind goes away, you are bringing back again. That is known as the process of dharana. We will come to know more elaborately about dharana, dhyanam, samadhi, which is known as dhyana swarupam. That is the main topic of this 6th chapter. We will deal with that in the next session, in the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.